gets the pick. And they're doing business on the road. It's an interconference NBA matchup. Buckle yourselves in, everybody. It's the NBA on 2K Sports, and here with Clark Kellogg and Steve Kerr and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan. Now a chance, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. The starting five on the floor. On the floor for Detroit, we've got Allen Iverson. Weber is out there with Wilkins. And there's B-Train. And it's Johnson in a point guard. You would think that a team like the Pistons, who struggled as they did, would have trouble with teams out west, but they really held their own.
You know, that was surprising. They weren't exactly taking the conference by storm, but they definitely were able to knock off a few of the powerhouses out there.
Boy, the floor really opened up for them there.
Sure did. Good job getting it started before the defense can get itself set.
Anthony again. It's Weber. Robinson sets a screen for Anthony. Jordan kicks to Nowitzki. That drops and it comes off an assist from Jordan. Nowitzki's got his first points in this one.
And to go back to what you said with the Pistons, they had a bad record against the West, but a lot of those games were close.
And the shot is good.
You know, he'll make you scratch your head and throw your hands up as a defender. I mean, you just don't know how to play.
Kidd kicks to Anthony. Here's Robinson. The shot will not go. And it's Detroit the other way.
For a team like the Pistons that wasn't going to make a lot of noise last year in terms of competing, I think it's a good sign that they did have some tough games against some of the Western Conference opponents where they did compete at a playoff-type level.
Gotta love the use of the bounce pass there. Perfect feed.
Here's Jordan. Rebound by the Pistons. And just under 2.5 minutes elapsed here in the first. Weber kicks to Wilkins. And he misses the go-ahead basket. Lakers have gone 3 of 5 shooting the ball so far. Kept alive. Another shot. Short. And it's Allen Iverson with the foul. Side Jordan. Johnson again. Kidd. Nowitzki inside. Stolen by Weber.
Well, despite that possession, something I've liked is that they've really been in control while getting out to this lead. They've kept the turnovers down. Boy, that pass was in the air a long time.
Long enough for him to get a finger on it anyway and send it out of bounds.
Johnson dishes to Iverson. Off the mark there with the three-point shot.
I wonder when you look back at it just how significant a win Dirk had when he was able to get his championship win.
Excellent communication between teammates on the alley-oop there.
And that's what you need to pull that off.
Well, both ends of that play, just fantastic.
And no good. Trying to use the glass.
defense did a pretty good job of closing off the middle once he got inside the lane.
Gervin's checked in for Jordan.
Well, they've really kind of struggled offensively here, so I think this timeout is for him to really draw something up, maybe get an easy two and get their confidence back.
You know, sometimes an easy basket out of a break is just what you need to get things back on track. Coaches always have plays specifically for that situation, coming out of timeouts for an opportunity to get a bucket.
And the Pistons decide to take their first timeout right here.
Strange to think that for so many years the Lakers would just devour and dominate teams from the East. Last year, the East got some payback.
Some changes. Russell, he's checked in for Robinson. Stoudemire comes in for Dirk Nowitzki. And it's Richmond in for Carmelo Anthony. So Detroit going with an almost entire new group here. Patrick Ewing's checked in for B-Train. Barkley comes in for Weber. It's coming early and often in the first quarter. Lakers lead by 8. We'll get right back to the action when we return. And the first quarter is in the books. Second about ready to get underway. Let's look at the energy stats, how the hustle game has been going for the Lakers.
Well, they're trying to play fast and trying to put the defense on their heels.
Well, another factor in their offense so far has been their ability to convert and score off turnover.
Nowitzki is out there with Robinson. And it's Miller. Then it's Mullen. And it's Anthony in the three, the small forward.
Oh, man, that was unreal.
Mark it up. Forget about going for the long-range bomb to cut into that lead. Just take it to the hoop, my friend. Take it to the hoop.
A brilliant throwdown.
Yeah, just exerting his authority out there. Virtually uncontested. It's nice to be able to add to the lead without Philly having to work for it.
Got a piece of it. And it's out of bounds to the Pistons as Detroit retains possession. Boomer, he's checked in for Miller. Quarter number two. We're about a minute in. Thomas dishes to Iverson. And the three off target.
Well, the problem was clear for Detroit last year. They just didn't shoot the ball very well. Not at the free throw line or from deep. And they just didn't have the floor spacing to be able to run a solid offense.
Los Angeles making a switch here. Jordan's checked in. Outside kid. Just 5 to shoot. And there's a whistle that goes on B-Train. That's his first foul.
You know, and being able to knock down threes and get to the free throw line and make free throws is so crucial, especially in how the game is played now. Shooting is so important. No wonder Detroit struggled like they did because they lacked perimeter shooting.
It's intercepted. Here's Weber inside, poke loose, and here's the fast break. Jordan leading the way. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him 2 chances at the free throw line here. That's on Allen Iverson. You guys mentioned the Pistons shooting problems last year. It's not an easy fix to do that from within.
Well, that's true. I mean, you can make some tweaks, but shooting is a skill that's pretty static in the NBA. I don't know how they're going to address it this year, but the Pistons must find a way to improve.
The Pistons shooting their first free throws of this game.
Lakers last season, and this is a remarkable factoid here, folks. That was only the 6th time in franchise history. Going all the way back to the 40s, the Lakers have missed the playoffs. Obviously, the Lakers fans are not accustomed to missing the postseason.
The drive by Jordan. They grab their own miss. And now the Pistons, fast break. Always going up for the alley-oop here. It's slammed in by Wilkins.
Maybe that'll ignite. Impossible not to get pumped up after that. At least I think that would be the case.
Well, you can see the immediate reaction of the guys on the bench. They are. Look at them. They are pumped up.
Yeah, they're geeked.
That's what those alley-oops do, though.
Anthony. He rebound by the Pistons. V-Train's got four rebounds now tonight. And for the Lakers last season, Steve, with the departure of Dwight Howard, you knew the team on paper had less talent, but the hope was that the chemistry would improve.
And I thought it did. The chemistry was good. Kevin, they just didn't have enough talent. And when Kobe and Nash went down, it didn't matter who was out there, who was coaching. You know, it was just going to be a situation where they were not going to be able to win enough games.
Wow, and that sort of showmanship is just deflating right now to a team trying hard to get back into this game like this.
Yeah, definitely a jam with emphasis. A big apostrophe or exclamation point. How about maybe even a question mark, Mark?
Well, you know what the questions are about now. It's their defense, that's for sure.
Well, it's a little strange to think of Detroit as being a team that runs, but they actually were better when they did run last year. They made good on a lot of opportunities in transition.
The drive by Jordan. Battles through traffic and lays it in. Jordan's got 5 points now in the quarter.
Well, you got to like his shot selection today. He set a good example for the rest of his teammates.
The three from Iverson. And good on the basket. Book it. Said, guys, you think of basketball in the Motor City, you think of a very deliberate game and Steve, tough D.
It had been the identity of basketball in this city for a long time, Kevin, but last year the Pistons were a top five team in fast break scoring. So, you know, when they run, they're at their best. So the city might be entering a new era in terms of the style of play.
Here's Weber. Wilkins passes to Weber. He shoot again. He squares up and sinks it. Now just a 2-point Laker lead. Kidd kicks to Richmond. Richmond left side. Off the screen. Nice touch on the bank shot. Richmond's got six.
Very effective screen to set up the jumper, and that was the key to that play.
Let's go to our sideline reporter, Doris Burton. Doris, what do you have?
Thank you, Kevin. As everyone knows, Amari Stoudemire has had to battle back from his share of numerous injuries, and he switched to a vegan diet in order to help stay healthy. He said it was tough, and when asked which foods he missed the most, he said, I love chicken, and I love Chilean sea bass. I missed it, but I wanted to stay strong. Guys?
Interesting. Thanks, Doris. So, timeout called here, the first for Los Angeles. Big group substitution here for the Lakers. Stoudemire's checked in for Nowitzki. Russell comes in for Anthony. Durbin's checked in for Michael Jordan. And Irving subbed in for Boomer. Irving attacking. Second shot opportunity. And Stoudemire lays it in. And the Lakers lead by six.
They're forcing the ball inside, and it's working beautifully.
Yeah, the defense has been futile here. Five of the last six field goals in the lane.
The Pistons shooting their fifth and sixth free throws of the game. That free throw missing. And he sinks the second.
Well, you know, for the last couple of seasons, we've seen the Lakers really struggle with injuries to their star players, and it shed a less than flattering light on the team's bench depth. It's forced guys to step into roles that perhaps they aren't quite ready to handle.
Thomas dishes to Smith. He kicks it to Bird. Back to Smith. And the rejection by Stoudemire. Here's Richmond. And again, it's the Lakers.
Whatever their plan was defensively that time, it didn't work. Not if it results in that shot.
And too long on the shot.
Boy, we don't see that too often. No defender on him, and he just clanks the open jumper.
In low to Russell. It's stolen by Barkley. No one near Smith as he lets it go. A second chance effort. Shot's good by Barkley.
He was the first one to react to that miss. Excellent anticipation on his part. A hustle play on the putback by him.
Richmond outside. It's stolen by Barkley.
And they'll probably let the clock wind down here.
Exactly. No need to give the ball back before the end of the quarter.
Here's Gervin. And he uses the glass on the layup. Gervin's got 12.
Well, it's been all about pace and space with them. Tempo, the fast break points, just a huge advantage.
Yeah, they've been looking to push it all the time and to get that early offense, and they're doing it well.
And that concludes the first half. The Lakers on top, up 9. We're going to step away briefly, but get you right back out here for the start of the third quarter after our halftime. The second half just about to get going here. And you know, George Gervin has been really making it happen.
Yeah, what a remarkable half, the way he attacked the rim and scored in the paint. Defenders, yeah, they were trying to slow him down any way possible, but he still got through.
Easier said than done when he's the penetrator. His speed and agility make him extremely hard to defend.
Checking out the group for Stan Van Gundy to start the second half. Johnson is up there with Allen Iverson. Then there's Dominique Wilkins. Then it's Weber. And it's B-Train in it, the pivot spot, manning the middle. Johnson, a wide open look. Good. And it's Iverson who picks up the assist. Iverson's got 3 assists in the game. The drive by Jordan. That drops. Jordan's got 13.
Has really shot the ball extremely well, as you'd expect. Like we say, he's been making sweet string music all day long.
Weber gets the bucket.
Nice move and finish. I think the halftime break gave him a second wind. He looks fresh.
And Anthony gets double teamed. The drive by Jordan. The dive for the ball. Kidd passes to Anthony. Here's Nowitzki. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot 2.
And the defense looking to protect the rim at all costs.
Yeah, I like that. A foul to save the layup. Make him earn it at the line.
Dirk Nowitzki last season back in the All-Star game is 12th in 13 seasons. He left the knee troubles of 2 seasons ago in the rearview mirror. He's in top form once again.
Weber with it. He's picked up by Jordan. That one off the back iron and out. Anthony again. It's Weber. And it's lights out with the foul. That is his first foul of the game.
And Nowitzki, even though late in his career, put up close to a 50-40-90 season, missed it by only fractions of a percentage point, scoring as well as ever, and turned in his best season as far as assist-to-turnover ratio goes.
B-Train passes to Wilkins. 6 on the shot clock. Johnson kicks to Wilkins. And good, coming off the assist by Magic Johnson. Wilkins has got 10.
Boy, they are passing the ball very crisply right now.
They sure are. That's 3 straight buckets that have come off of assists.
And Dirk Nowitzki scaling the ranks of the all-time top scorers. Last season, Stevie passed guys like Jerry West and Rick Barry, Kevin Garnett, Alex Inglis, the great John Havlicek, Dominique Wilkins, Stephen, and Oscar Robertson.
Think about that list that you just rattled off. That's incredible. Dirk moving into the top 10. And, you know, with a game based on skill and size, there's no telling how high he'll get on that list before it's all said and done.
And Detroit Pistons, a proud franchise, of course, from 03 to 08, six consecutive trips to the Eastern Conference Finals. Mm-hmm. And Clark in 2004, the NBA title.
But the rebuild process has had its hiccups, Kevin, its speed bumps, if you will, some questionable free agent signings. There's talent there, but this team hasn't quite figured out how to come together.
The drive by Jordan. Shot denied. Anderson again. It's Kidd. Good on that shot. And with that, the Los Angeles lead is cut down now to just 6 points with that basket from Allen Iverson. Los Angeles calls timeout. And as with any timeout at this point of the game, important to go over the strategies that are working and those that are needed in terms of adjustments. And, of course, the opportunity, guys, to get hydrated with Gatorade for coming back out of the floor. We've seen some good action so far, and there's more of it to come.
Yeah, this game has been physical. It's been fast. It's been high-paced. So anytime you're in a situation like this where it's really a hard-fought game, critical to keep yourself hydrated throughout.
And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here. A lot of strange things happened last season, but one of them was having a playoff bracket with no Laker presence.
Very well, odd. Don't expect that to happen very, very often. I mean, it's rare when that is the case. It's been a while since they were completely left out of the playoff picture, and that's not going to be the norm going forward.
Robinson sets a screen for Kidd. Terrific design on the pick play, and he lays it in.
That's just a case of two teammates working perfectly together. One setting the screen and the other using it to get that separation.
And it's Johnson penetrating. Fires from 14. Kicks it out to Iverson. Goes up on the wing. And he gets it to go. Iverson's got nine.
For the Lakers, it was the first time since the 04-05 season that they didn't play postseason basketball.
And it's Allen Iverson with the foul. And that'll be his third foul so far. Russell, he's checked in for Los Angeles. So Detroit going with an almost entire new group here. Ewing's checked in for B-Train. Barkley comes in for Weber. Thank you. Pistons trailed by four. Anthony out there with Nowitzki. And it's Robinson. And it's Boomer. And it's Jordan in the two spot. That's the Laker five. Weber can't hit.
Usually, if he gets to the rim, he's converting it into points. But the defense stood tall there.
Here's Jordan. Not enough on that one as it misses. Detroit's gone 3-7 tonight from three-point territory. Puts one up from 19. Rejected by Robinson. Kidd with it. Wilkins picks him up. Kidd kicks to Jordan. Kidd attacking. Nowitzki dishes to Jordan. Clock at four. Kidd passes to Jordan. Out of bounds, the Lakers will take possession. Los Angeles leading by four. Kidd kicks to Robinson. And it is flushed down with a nice jam. Well, now they're just going to town on it.
Yeah, you'd think these defenders would have done a little more to put a stop to that stuff, Kevin. But so far, no go.
Well, a phenomenal aerial assault there, fellas. His shooting has been so good today, and he may have to take it upon himself to try to get his club out of this hole.
And they double up Jordan. And the Lakers with possession here. Nowitzki kicks to Anthony. Outside Kidd. Shot clock at five. Robinson sets a screen for Jordan. And he connects on the jumper. The screen did the trick. And the Lakers lead.
Oh! Are you kidding me?
That was a power punch right there. Talk about putting something extra on it. That dunk was way over the top.
Close game or not, Clark, you know, he's going to finish firm when he gets the space.
Still, I mean, it's startling that he'd even try that right now.
The Lakers call time here.
Yeah, he definitely saw some things that were not working for them out there. And now he's going to make some adjustments.
I'm not sure what it was, but he clearly wanted something to change out there.
Let's go quickly over to Doris Burke for an update.
Gentlemen, Byron Scott had some advice for his team in that last timeout. He tried to really fire them up to bring it home, saying, all night, you have all rest after the final buzzer. For now, we have to lay it on the line and try to bring it home. Guys, back to you.
Pass to Kidd. Jordan against Johnson. The drive by Jordan. Gets to the rim for two with the D all over him.
Well, he wasn't fazed at all by the bigger man on him. And on the low block, I thought he might be.
You know, Steve, I thought maybe he'd prefer to bring him out to the perimeter, but whatever works, go to it.
What a play to get to the rim. I think they're going to take the aggressive approach down the stretch.
Lakers have gone 3-4 in field goal attempts since getting things started here in the fourth. Outside Kidd. Pass to Robinson. Jordan up top. He dishes it to Anthony. From about 19 feet, kicks it out to Nowitzki. Detroit with the rebound. B-Train's got rebound number 8 now on the night. Nowitzki with the steal. Jordan with it. Iverson picks him up. Jordan again. Wilkins. From 11 feet away. And he gets that one to go off the front iron. 19 points for Michael Jordan. And breaking down some numbers here, the hustle stats for Los Angeles.
Their high-energy defensive effort has paid off for them, guys, with more than a few steals over the course of the ball game.
And another thing they're doing is really taking advantage of fast-break opportunities, scoring some easy baskets.
On defense, Detroit have given up just 8 points in the fourth quarter. Oh, that's offensive interference.
How about Michael Jordan in this one? He's got 19 points and the one steal. He's been their leader, stirring the drink at the offensive end and then anchoring the defense.
Well, it's a good example, Clark, of how you set the table for the rest of your teammates. He's really brought focus and energy to this game.
Kicks it out to Johnson. The drive by Iverson. From the top of the key, he buries it. And the Pistons lead by one.
He's such a clutch shooter, Kevin. He just lives for the big shot.
And now here's Johnson, a fast break chance.
This is what you love, guys. Superb defense, a great steal, and just like that, they add 2 points to this narrow lead.
And you just cannot afford to give up plays like that at this stage of a tight ball game, guys.
Good. Now it's a 5-point Detroit lead.
Really not hard to see why they're giving up points on this run. I mean, they've just given them too many looks inside.
Yeah, I mean, they're just getting pounded in there. The defense not offering much resistance. They've got to force the ball back out to the perimeter.
Here's P-Train. Kicks it out to Iverson. Iverson right side. Second chance shot. And that one's good. They got on this roll a while ago, and they just haven't looked back.
Got to continue to put pressure on the defense by probing inside. That's what's really working for them.
And when you're doing the job they are inside, it takes pressure off the perimeter guy.
Los Angeles calls timeout. They're behind by 7. 1:30 left in the fourth quarter. And the Lakers with some changes. Mullins checked in for Anthony. Miller comes in for Jordan. Kyrie Irving subbed in for Boomer. And it's Johnson penetrating. Here's P-Train. Can't hit the turnaround jumper.
It's going to take something special, maybe a miracle, for them to come back right now.
How about a little luck?
Yeah, he put himself in great position to finish that break off, guys.
Yep, right to the rack.
Johnson dishes to Iverson. Back to Johnson. ...52 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. That drops. V-Train's got the lead up to 7 now for the Pistons.
Well, that putback's about as easy as it's gonna get. You have to put a body on someone down there.
Well, no box out, that's the result you get right there.
Iverson with the bucket.
A serious game-clinching run. They've taken off here. Impressive.
No backing off. What a surge at the right time.
Miller, no luck.
He's been the guy on the boards today, no question.
Steve, you're all over it. I mean, his numbers back it up. He's been working extremely hard out there.
The drive by Iverson. Grabber, the pass to Johnson. Again, Johnson missing. Now Mullen. Here's Miller. It's hauled in by Allen Iverson.
Yeah, that's a low percentage shot right there.
Yeah, it sure is. I mean, he's got to be thinking out there a little bit. Make the pass in that situation. Don't force a bad shot.
And so the Pistons take the win. Well, it was a solid win, Clark.
Yeah, it was, and I think it came down to will more than skill. They went out and got this one.
It's time to say so long. For Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan, along with our 2K Sports Group, thanking you for tuning in. Now it's time to present our Jordan Player of the Game, Magic Johnson. Thank you.